Beautiful. Hello, hello. Welcome everyone to wherever you are in the world. Welcome to the inaugural office hours of 2022. I am here with the wonderful Patricia, who is helping us lead this session. You have, of course, myself, the host, Keone Chong, and we have this wonderful Systm community in front of us. So let's kind of just recap kind of where we are and where the community's at. And let's kind of kick off today's session today. So and let's get this thing started. So our mission, right? Why are we here? So when we started this Systm, our mission was to activate creative leaders globally to tackle society's biggest design challenges through design, Web3 technology, and community. Our vision is to empower each and every one of you guys, whether it's through design frameworks, whether it's through development and development resources, whether it's strategy and facilitation skills, or whether it's just business development, you know, go-to-market strategies, things of that nature. We want to help you play a key role in the transformation of our planet, in redesigning the businesses and the enterprises that exist now and helping transform them into more sustainable, you know, businesses. And we want to do that through co-creation. This co-creation, this experience that we're having, this vision, this ability for us to come together and synthesize all of our collective powers and talents. Guys, we are the Systm. So, you know, a little recap, where did the Systm come from? How did we even get here? Well, it started with CORE, which is a brand discovery framework. It's still available now in its Web2 format, and that's at coreismagic.com. But that will transition just like we're transitioning. So if you're checking this out on YouTube, or if you're checking this out, you know, on Instagram, TikTok, wherever you're at, we invite you to like, subscribe, and comment, because this is an ongoing conversation. And the future is being written every day, and we as a community collectively are articulating that. So let's talk a little bit about today's agenda and what we're going to cover. We're going to do a drop-in for about 15 minutes, and that's around the state of the creative industry. It's, I think, really important for us to kind of dive in and understand where we are and kind of orient ourselves as we step into 2022. Then we're going to have our traditional CORE Q&A. So any design problems, challenges, concerns, themes, topics that you guys like, to discuss, I'm here to help you guys, you know, find clarity and understanding. And not just myself, you know, we all have very disparate talents and experiences, and that's the power of community, the abundance. We're going to lean on that. And then we're going to end with the upload. So, you know, 10 minutes and kind of what we got from today's conversation and how we can take it into the weekend and into our communities and into the next week. So let's start a little bit with understanding the schedule of the programming and the broadcast that is happening. This is season one, and so the challenge is kind of getting the team and the space station oriented and starting to build out the teams. So this first season is going to be a little bit slow, but with each season, it's going to ramp up as we collectively get more coordinated in our efforts, as, you know, we get tighter and have a grasp of, you know, the responsibilities to execute these kinds of broadcasts and the contributions from our community. So here's our first season for February. We had our season launch, which was last week. Today, we have our very first inaugural office hours. And then next week, we'll have design therapy. And as you can see, these are going to be once a week broadcasts that happen on Friday, and they are going to alternate design therapy and office hours. So with that all out of the way, let's dive into today's session and today's drop-in. So today's drop-in is, what trends are you noticing in 2022 as a creative? Once again, you know, we'd like for you just to kind of share with us your name and your location and what do you do? And then what trends are you noticing? And I'll model that. So this is Keone Chong. I'm in downtown LA. I am a Web3 strategist. I focus on culture and community. And what trends am I noticing in 2022 as a creative? I'm noticing a lot of trends. The big one that I'm noticing is this trend towards community. Like, what does community look like? How do we as a brand, you know, address community? And what does the future of that look like? Just about everyone has been asking that question to me. And yeah, that's the trend that I'd like to share. So I'd love to pass this on and let's keep this in flow. So when you drop in, just go ahead and select another person to join in on the call. I am going to go with Pape. What's up, brother?
Hello, hello. Hello, Kenny. Before dropping in, I just want to let you know that I got into the Discord of an amazing NFT project of one of my favorite artists. I will share the link in the chat later. I'm so happy. My name is Aurelio, but I go by Pape. My location is Panama City, or as I like to call it, a small paradise in Central America. I'm an artist. I do illustrations and I tell characters through, I tell stories through characters. And the trends that are as well with Keone, I've been seeing a lot of community and a lot of illustration popping up. Like with the NFTs, I feel that illustration is like gaining a lot of terrain, and a lot of 2D and 3D illustration is something that I'm seeing a lot. Gradients as well is something that I've seen coming back, and type. I've seen like a huge exploration in typography and playing with it, and it's like a really interesting time because it's like a lot of new things happening and a lot of remixes going on. But I guess what interests me the most is in character design. I'm seeing a lot of 2D, like really simple shaped illustrations that I love and that actually match the style that I really like. So that's something that I'm seeing as a creative, and I'm Pape and I'm complete. And I would go with Mauro.
All right, thank you, Pape. Okay, so my name is Mauro. I'm based in Ensenada, Mexico. And in terms of trends, you know, I think one trend that I've been starting to see is the reemergence of like the 90s, 2000s sort of aesthetic. So coming back. And this, you know, it happens right? in fashion, it happens in every single industry. And I'm starting to see some like elements and some things about like the early 90s sort of coming back, especially in Web3, right? We're starting to see those trends, but now like really evolved and really polished and even a little bit more minimalistic in some ways. So, and the same as Pape mentioned, right? I think a lot of illustration is coming into the fold and it's getting integrated in the whole like brutalist sort of movement, which is really interesting because they're also working with that whole like 90s sort of era. And yeah, that's what I'm noticing. I'm Mauro and I'm complete. And let's go with Adriana.
Hi, I'm Adriana. I'm from Mexico. I'm a designer slash photographer for now. And I'm just seeing like how communities are gathering for imagining the future, how they are finding new ways to just create together and find themselves into some vision that they can have understanding, and yeah, experimenting into towards future and having more engagement, but in a very authentic way. And yeah, just finding new ways. I think that's the trends that I'm currently being able to witness, and I'm very happy for that, and I'm grateful to be living in this time for that change to happen, and we are part of that, so that makes me more happy. And I will pick gender.
Thanks, Adriana. Well, I'm gender. I'm based in London. I'm a UX design strategist. Trends, I guess. Well, over Christmas, I was sitting next to my nephew, and he was playing games, and he was connected to friends, family. He was playing football, and then he was collecting players. And everything was so fast, but I think I learned a lot sitting next to him around, I guess, NFTs and skins. So I think he, the younger generation are way ahead. In terms of design, I guess I use the word blended. Maybe because I worked in e-learning. And when I worked in e-learning, digital was important, but face-to-face was just as important. So the two things always are just as important. You can't, only say digital is more important, because face-to-face is just as important. And it may the last project I worked on was on a gym, and okay, we had online kind of apps and you can do workouts, but the personal trainers and that coaching side was just as important. So it's the same thing, you know, anything with, you know, mind, body and soul, it's digital is important, but face to face is just as important. So that's what I just digital is important, but face to face is just as important. Who shall I pick?
Yeah, thank you for that. That was really powerful. Brian hasn't gone yet.
Thanks. My name is Brian Jimenez. I am a brand strategist and a creative director. Also a podcast producer from the Los Angeles area. And I have a small a boutique agency. I do strategy and brand related work, including branding, promotional things, and consulting on that, in those spaces. And now obviously doing some Web3 stuff as well. I've noticed some trends. Some good, some bad. I'll start with the bad trend, which is with NFTs, is that there's a ton of copyright and IP issues. And they're gonna, this is just the beginning of the IP and copyright issues that we'll be seeing from NFTs. And that's likely because of the misunderstanding of how the Web3 overlaps with the rest of the real world, including the legal world. And so, the legal world doesn't really know how to handle. I mean, they can barely handle software. That's been, you know, decades already. So they have no grasp on NFTs. So it's we're going to be seeing a little bit of stumbling on the NFT, IP, and copyright side. But nothing that a good conversation can't fix, or at least get some direction on. So we have that advantage as a community to be able to have those conversations. A good trend on the positive side. It just like Pape was mentioning, illustration. I've noticed that the NFT space is exploring a lot with different formats. I know there's like other types of art, like music NFTs and mixed reality things. But I think illustration is really taking a huge leap. People are exploring different ways to do that. They're doing so with games and collectibles and things like that. They are in my view, kind of growing pains because everything's jockeying for position to see what's going to win out. There's a lot of fluff and a lot of projects that are kind of not too good. They're just kind of copying everyone else. But I think that's just a part of the process of kind of figure out what this really means and the value that it provides. And again, they're just growing pains. We all experience them. I think that this is going to lead to some really important realizations in Web3 and will allow people to both express themselves and be able to transact socially and financially in really cool, interesting ways. Web3 is definitely the future. So that's, I'm complete. Who hasn't gone?
Ariza, have you gone yet?
No. So, Arsenio Savage calling from Mexico City. What trends facilitator and developer? What trends do I notice? I would say one global trend that is maybe not related to aesthetic, but more towards shifting in business practice more from extractive practices towards regenerative one. And I would say core is kind of part of that. And I'm seeing that more and more businesses are kind of trying to operate on a different level, but I think that's kind of still in transition and we will need guidances and kind of new practices that enable people to kind of conceive their business on a different level. So yeah, I would say move from exploitative kind of practices that is just getting started. So yeah, I'm complete and I think I choose Anna or Mao.
I can actually read Mao's. So Mao is in Colombia. He's a business coaching and creative collective owner. And for him, he says he's seeing a lot of people hopping into NFTs and into the crypto space. That's totally on brand and on trend, Mauricio. And I've been seeing that as well, right? There's been a huge shift from creative, from brands that are looking at this and realizing that this is the next level of technology. And if you do not evolve and step onto this new, I wouldn't say they're platforms, what I think the term is called is proto-forms, where like they're protocols in addition to platforms. And that community is absolutely essential. But yeah, I think you're right on track. Thank you for that.
Hi, Keone. Actually, hey. I'd like to add something to that. I was just on a call. Please. I just got out. Yeah, I've seen, not only have I seen people like jump into that, but like there's so much building to do in it. Like I think it's this game called like Sandbox, I think it is. Mm-hmm. And, like people like are getting there to build, I don't know, like tools and what, like it's a Web3 like metaverse type thing. Mm-hmm. Where people play and why not, and there is a lot of people getting into that to build the tools like quite literally in game for people to play with, meaning like cars and whatever, like also like architecture and land inside these virtual spaces. So yeah, kind of wanted to add on that as well, which is really incredible that all of that is happening.
Thank you so much, brother. And that's right on trend, man. I think we're all thinking that. Let's bring someone else into the chat. Would anyone else like to drop in? Maybe Christina, would you like to share maybe some trends that you're seeing in the design industry?
Hey guys, Christina here. Can you guys hear me?
Yep, we can. Thank you.
So trends in the industry that I'm seeing. Well, definitely a lot more remote work and more of community based projects. That's kind of what I'm seeing. I'm wondering like what you guys might think as well in terms of that.
Well, yeah, we're gonna have actually a conversation. We're gonna debate this a little bit further. So that's a great point. And Patricia, did you get that? Beautiful, awesome. Well, let's ask if anyone else would like to drop in, anyone else before we move on to the next section. No? Awesome. So thank you guys all so much for sharing. I'm gonna share a little bit of research that I've been covering. And then we're going to end that with just kind of recapping some of the highlights from your experiences and what you guys are discovering. So, you know, today's conversation, of course, is about, you know, the state of the creative industry. And the reason that I thought it was important for us to start it off with this theme is because it is... I'd like for us to take the approach this year into looking at the opportunities that are happening in front of us. I think we're in unprecedented times right now. And I think there's a lot going on that we need to be concerned of as professional creatives. Economically, things are extremely volatile. Depending on where you are in the world, you can be almost in a fight or flight situation. And with all of these industries in flux, with the world's economic systems in flux, I think it's even more pertinent to be able to look at the real opportunities that we can have as creatives that will allow for us to bring material change into our lives. And when I talk about material change, I'm talking about real jobs, I'm talking about real financial impact, and an ability to take care of not only yourself, but you know, our communities around us, our immediate families, things in that nature. And that's what we are really focused on. So I did some research and I'm gonna cover the top four really high level trends that we have been noticing and that we have, you know, pulled in our reporting. And then we're gonna talk a little bit about some of the stuff that you guys brought up. And then we'll dive into a Q&A with any projects or questions or concerns that you might have. So the big thing as a whole is cultural design. And this is, we are looking now at the full holistic presentation of this culture as opposed to brand, right? And we'll talk a little bit about brand versus culture when we get into storytelling, but this is the world that we're in right now. The Web 2 world, the extractive economies that we've been accustomed to are not going to translate into Web 3 in the same way that they existed. And that means that you have to expand beyond what was strictly around revenue and now incorporate culture, which is about what are the ethics and values that we're using when we design this brand, this company, this thing. What kind of sustainability are we looking at from a world impact? How is community integrated into this? And then ultimately, it's about connection. We're back to relationships, right? Like, how can you have the emotional connections? How can you have the feels from when I hang with you guys? What we have right here, what we're experiencing right now is a great challenge that a lot of these companies, a lot of these collectives are going through, which is how to build connection, how to design connection. Next, let's talk a little bit about the spaces in which these things are happening. So AR and VR, and when we talk about AR and VR, really what we're looking at are different applications that are occurring, that are driving what is the metaverse and what is Web3. We had Sandbox come up earlier. Collabland is another form that is in similar nature. And that is these immersive environments. When we look at some of the top performing companies in the last few years, right? We're talking about like Axie Infinity. We're talking about Roblox, right? Ginder, you brought up, you know, you're like, I'm sitting next to my nephew and I'm just watching these games and I'm looking at all these skins and I'm like, wow, what is going on? This is the cultural community design, and these are the opportunities that is really the hotbed of innovation right now. Then, you know, Mauricio, you brought up NFTs in the space where people are moving into NFTs. You know, I'll share this with you guys, and I've shared this a couple of times in some of my high level conversation with C-list, our C-level managers and founders. And I look at NFTs as the new website, right? Websites used to be that point of origin where a potential audience, community member, fan, consumer, user would meet and learn about this brand, right? But now we're moving into culture. So what is the point of impact for the culture? What is that point of understanding? I believe that that first thing is going to be an NFT, right? It's like when you met somebody and they presented to your personality and they gave you a handshake, or they gave you a business card, right? And you had those feels and you were in that space. That's where I think it's going, and that's what I think NFTs are going to be. Then you've got tokens, right? Tokens is the way in which we, how can I put it? The way in which we build a sustainable community, right? It's a way that we track the activities. Barrett said it best on one of our Twitter Spaces calls that that money is just the exchange of human behavior, right? So if we were to look at tokens as that that vector or that point, then it's how are we tracking community? How are we tracking the culture? How are we looking at the growth and the influencers in the space and making sure that it's a healthy, happy, vibrant thing? And then ultimately, we're at DAOs, right? DAOs is the highest level. DAOs is sort of that organizational, that human synchronization, that place where we can go and manage all of these kinds of activities and cultures. So that is the really exciting thing. And that is the trends that we are seeing. Next, let's talk a little bit about inclusivity. So the challenge that we have now, and it happens every single time there's a considerable leap in opportunity, and that is how do we ensure that those that were less than, not less than, had less than us in terms of opportunity, in terms of education, how do we make sure that we are onboarding everyone into this space and giving everyone equal access to build, to create, to lead? And that is about diversity. That's making sure that, you know, the communities that we're in are not homogenous. They don't look like everyone else. And that's one of the most exciting things, that when we have these sessions, you know, we literally have multiple languages, multiple cultural perspectives, multiple ages, multiple creative talents, right? We have this deep diversity of understanding, of leadership, of worldview, you know, and I always posit this, you know, when the question around diversity and the need for it comes in the door, and I always say, you know, you can actually look at it mathematically. You know, if you were to look at an object in 2D, it's flat. You take an object and you add another perspective, all of a sudden it's 3D and it's this thing, it's an object. You add another dimension and it's 4D, and all of a sudden you can have motion and trajectory, right? You add another vector and all of a sudden it could become this amorphous thing. And every single view, every single exploration in that space, you get this really great and powerful space to really get in and enjoy, you know, the depth and the feels. So yeah, next let's go into storytelling. Storytelling is, and we talked a little bit about it, and that is about, interesting. All right, what's going on? This is exactly what we're talking about. Inclusivity, diversity, access, right? These things are important. How can we give other members access into our community, into the work that we're doing, into this vision that we're building, and do it in a way that can respect them as individuals, and they can integrate into our community. And then lastly, education, right? This is a place where we have to be educators. It is so early. The numbers are anywhere from 1 to 2 to 3% of all internet users are in this space. So that means we have a huge threshold of opportunity for our community to make sure that they're in the space early enough to be able to thrive like we can. All right, so let's end, and I'll end it with the storytelling. Brand versus culture. This is what we're dealing with now. And we have been in a place where we have built and designed around brand. Brand has the KPIs of revenue. It has the KPIs of new user growth. It is a very hard and non-emotional space. Culture is both, right? I used to describe branding as where culture meets commerce. Now that we're in this space of cultural storytelling, we no longer have to worry about the commerce. The commerce is integrated. It is a fundamental component of the work that we're doing. This is why NFTs are culture. It is the behavioral economics. It is the art and the visual representation. And it is the feels, the way that we feel. And how do we tell our story as a community, right? We're doing it here. We're doing it in an inclusive way. I think we're really trying to represent the future of community, of what we can be right here and right now. So when we look at some of the Systm trends that we identified, we talked about IRL face-to-face connections like we're having here. We talked about some of the technical elements, gradients, illustration, and typography. The challenges of community and integration, IP and copyright issues, right? That's that Web 2 world shifting into Web 3. Web 3 legalities, right? That's a big one. And then community-based projects and remote working. Powerful stuff. So before we move on, I just want to end with what Jose had shared. And, Jose says that for him, the trends that he sees are being a Web3 community builder, self-expression, creatives fulfilling their projects using NFTs and tokens. And it's really about recognizing self in this new world and how to leverage these tools. So with that, I am done. I would like to spend a couple minutes and just connect with the community, open the door, bring everyone to the stage and share any thoughts, how does that sound for 2022 and how does that relate to you? I'm really interested to hear. And I'll leave the floor open. Come on up, Brian.
Yeah, I think these are necessary conversations. And important ones that I think are going to help everyone to get a fuller grasp of the changing landscape. And it's going to help us to externalize things that we're probably thinking about or that are in the back of our minds, and we'll be able to talk about them openly and, in an environment where we don't have to be afraid what we say. And so I see great things coming from this system. They're already coming out from the system, even greater things.
Would anyone else like to share their thoughts, just that little overview? Bob, welcome, brother.
Oh, my brother. wow, that was an amazing, amazing episode just now with that bombing. Like, I've been bombed, but not quite to that degree. I just wanted to check in and emphatically support the idea that the trends we see here, both how we're going to apply them internally and what we're seeing externally. Like, this is spot on. The interesting meetings I'm getting ready to have next week are to talk with the Washington State Group Health Foundation, which is an organization that remains after Kaiser Permanente, which is a massive healthcare organization, came up into Washington and absorbed Group Health Cooperative, which was a healthcare provider in Washington. And what they left the Group Health Foundation with was hundreds of millions of dollars that are now going to be distributed through grants to communities on health and welfare issues with an incredible focus on diversity, equity, and inclusion. So we had an initial conversation with them. We're going to have another conversation next week. And the approach we want to suggest to them is the formation of a DAO around this within and including the foundation and the constituency of the grant writers. So why I share that is because at the same time I'm having these kind of conversations that seem to be more entertainment based or maybe popular culture based that are happening in Web3, I think that the utility, the accessibility, the transparency, all of that wrapped up this year, I think is the year that there's going to be a great getting of that, right? Like that people are going to see past like the PFP NFT trend, you know, which is kind of like in a signal to noise way, drowning out the greater benefit and utility of Web3. I think that's going to pop. And I think that we're all going to see a lot of people go, oh, right. And it's going to be in places like community development, healthcare, advocacy, et cetera. So I'm getting ready for that because that is where I want to put my energy, because those kind of returns on that kind of community give back and build out, you know, as you say, Keone, the beauty of Web3, and I'm convinced that the beauty of karma in general is the revenue follows good thought, good intention, good movement. You know, so I just wanted to share that because that's something that has come up in the last couple of days with me. And it's so consistent with the message that you were delivering today, Keone, that I was moved to give it to all of you.
Can I piggyback on off that real quick?
Yeah, please, Brian.
Bob, nice to see you, by the way. I think that's partially what I was referring to as well when I was talking about earlier that we're seeing a lot of exploration in the space and jockeying for position, because it's happening in the entertainment space and the art space, because that's a space where it can happen, right? It can't happen in the highly structured organizations. There's no room for play per se, right? There's a little bit of room, but it's usually out in the dark corner where the spider webs are. And so this is the time to be having these conversations, figuring this out, like Bob was saying, because it can happen in this space, and then it'll slowly be migrated into the more structured spaces. It has to be assimilated gradually into the over structured organizations, and so having it go in too fast is too much of a shock. And you get questions about the ROI, and chief financial officers running numbers and things. Exactly. So, like, that's it. Bye.
Beautiful, man. Yeah, and you know, it's like the challenge. Like, what is the KPI on a healthy community? How do you quantify that? It can't be quantified. It's a qualitative, assertion. And that means you've got to have feels, you've got to have empathy, you have to be able to connect, right? So yeah, thank you so much for that share. Pape, what's up, brother?
Thank you, Kenny. Thank you for that share. And I have been thinking a lot about what you were saying about culture and community and story and how all these three elements come together, and where this brand has a space between these three. And like, me focusing a lot into storytelling, what I'm seeing a lot is that brand has become for me just one extra character to tell the story that brings together the people that build the culture and build the community. And it's something that I've been seeing a lot in psychotropic, and how the brand is just, it's selling not because of the graphics or just the graphics. The graphics are cool. People love the t-shirts, but they love what we're talking about and the story we're sharing. And I've been practicing a lot to that, the culture that I'm bringing together. I'm not building it from scratch. It's something that I've been a part of all the time. You know, I'm a music lover. I love meditation. I love consciousness. I love mindfulness. I love character design, and I'm putting all of this together into the brand in a point where I'm seeing how me as an artist and having the brand, it's become just a white canvas for me to express this story. And before, I used to fight a lot with, okay, Psychotropic is my clothing brand, but then I have Pape, that I have my personal story. And I just, this year I decided to put everything together and start using the brand as the container for all of the characters. And then I become just one character, because the culture is then psychotropic. Like, that's what I want it to become. And once I allowed that, it opened the space for new characters that inside the culture, like, build the community. So it's something that I'm super excited. Like, I've been working a lot in my personal project, that is like now Psychotropic. I see it completely as my personal project. And I'm excited to bring this into Web3, but I don't have any rush, because I know the foundation is culture and community. And that's something that I want to build in real life. I want to bring people together here. And then from that foundation, from the data, the conversation that I have with people, that's what I want to take into Web3. So I just wanted to share that. It's some thoughts that came to my head, and thank you for the share, everyone. Pape, and I'm complete.
We'll share, Pape. Thank you for us. You know, and you've been sharing a little bit in some of the work that you've been doing. Like, you know, you talked about how you were working with the client and you were like, here's my story, right? Here's where I come from, right? Here's how I, as an individual, can bring my culture and my provenance and my heritage into the work that you're doing, and here's how we can co-create together. So yeah, one of these days we'll have to do a little breakdown, and you have to share that, like a little fire, you know, recap. But that would be great. Adriana, please come on up.
Sorry, I'm having some technical issues. For me, I think it's like this new opportunity for us creatives to be very entitled of what we do and how we contribute in a project or a vision or a community, and we choose where to put ourselves. And that's new for us, and it gives us the opportunity to explore more where we want to go, what we do, or what we are not really like experts in, but we are trying to push ourselves into these new environments, and this gives us just so much more opportunities to grow. And not just like, I'm a designer and I'm a photographer, so it's new jobs popping there that can enable you to be something different of what you have envisioned for yourself. And also the opportunity to join different workspaces with different cultures, ambitions, and purpose, that it gives you more freedom also to find yourself in different ways. So I think that's very important for me, and sometimes it's overwhelming. I will not lie, because it's so new, everything is so new, but I think it's a wonderful time to be, because everything is so new. So it's like nothing is written like properly, so it's just beautiful to see how things grow, and you grow with them, and you decide if you want to follow or not, or where to put yourself. So I think that's a very wonderful time to be alive, to just grow. And the most important thing for me is community. So that's why I popped here, because I see how much we have been growing since we started, and how we are more powerful when we come together. and we share our experience and the things that we really are engaging more in this new environment. And yeah, I learned from you and I'm very happy to be here. And I think that's for me the most amazing thing, to be alive now, to be able to work and co-create with people from all over the world, with no matter our difference, we come together and we fight for what we believe. So yeah, I think that's for me amazing. So I'm grateful. Thank you.
Yeah, right. You know, what you're just sharing right there is really this this fly that we have right here, right? Inclusivity, diversity, access, education, right? How do we make sure that we can all come and arrive as we are and share our own stories? Thank you for that share. Let's go back to Arsenije. What's up, brother?
Yeah, in noticing the trends, and also I think I have this week so many meetings and kind of met so many people that I noticed, like, I don't know, it's on one end kind of normal, but on the other end, I think it's wild that in one week I kind of speak with person from India, then from person from US, then from person from Brussels. And then they are, I think something bigger is happening. And I did not know, I kind of know, you can notice that if you're following Twitter, but I think when you engage on day to day, like just in DAOs and just in conversation, I think I was just thinking, and I mean, it's also kind of question to you all, do you remember kind of time when you're able to in kind of in one week jump on like five different calls that are kind of addressing maybe same cause or different cause from the same perspective? I was just questioning myself, and kind of I think although I was participating in forums and all that, I don't remember a time like this. And then also I have kind of question for all of you, which I don't know if it's time for questions, but I mean, it's kind of question and maybe kind of open question is like how can we better kind of bring that different future through our day-to-day operation, and kind of what would that mean, starting maybe from strategy and then moving to design? Is it related to kind of with who we engage and with what projects we do, or is it something more that we can do in a sense when we encounter some businesses that are maybe dying because of or are kind of still into exploitative mindset? What is kind of our responsibility of that? And also, do you, any of you, kind of remember the time when you were able to kind of jump from city to city in a one way? I'm complete.
No, I really love that. And you know, we're coming up on the end of today's session. And I think that's actually a perfect segue into what is going to be our upload, right? You know, we covered a lot today. We talked about a lot of opportunities, you know, and so I'd like to ask that question to the community sort of as your takeaway. How can you, and you know, I'll share this so that everyone can see because I'm writing this in real time. There we go. So how can, you know, and this is an individual question, so I'm posing it to you as an individual. How can you take your own unique, special skills, talent, and experience to build the future that we discussed today? So I'll model that. You know, state of the industry in 2022, we've talked about all of this really incredible opportunity in space. The question is, you know, how can we take our own unique special skills, talent, and experience to build the future that we discussed today? For me, it is about exploration, it is about education, and it is about mentorship. So, you know, this program that we have here in the NFT lab is about education. You know, the mentorship is opening up the opportunities to the community, right? To the folks that we have here on this call, to sharing the exciting developments, to teach you guys how to do that. And for me, like, those are the ways that I am, you know, taking my skills, talent, and experience to build the future that we discussed today. Let's go on to Patricia. You have your hand raised.
Yes.
I'd love to hear what you have to share.
For me, it's definitely access. I feel like I've had this mentality that because I'm from Manila or if I'm from the Philippines, that I have limited access to opportunities, to mentorship and all that. And when I joined this community 2 years ago through this space, this webinar, I grew so much, and I feel like the time that we have, when Arce was talking about, do you remember jumping from city to city in just a week? Like, and for me, the power of us connecting online and being able to experience the what we have here, like learning so much, applying it in the quest. And I think for me, that's the testimony that no matter what background you're from, what your age is, and even you'll find your community and your people. And there are, and I'm so happy that Web3 is empowering this also, that I look forward to the future, and that's why I'm paying it forward, because I want to have the opportunity that I have now and the access that I have, I want to pay it forward for others to experience. So I guess that's what I'm saying, is connecting communities, connecting people. Like, that's, at the end of the day, my human values and who I am as a leader, as a creative, that I can use that in no matter, even if you think that our actions are small, it will be a ripple effect at the end of the day. So I don't know if I'm making sense, but that's it. I'm complete.
You are making sense. And thank you for that share. Very powerful. Would anyone else like to come up and share their upload? How can you take your special skills, talent, and experience to build the future that we discussed today? Not sure. Well, you know, it all starts with connection, and it starts with the relationship. I think it starts with just sharing what you know and sharing what you would like to know, right? As Jose says, it's learn, teach, and teach, learn. It's the virtuous cycle. You know, my father always told me that the most important person in a community was the educator. Pape, welcome to the stage, brother. I'd love to hear your share.
Thank you, Kenny. No, I read what Jose wrote on the chat about learning, teaching, and I feel that this month that I did my hero journey completely, like, it's easy to forget how you got to today, like everything that you have to overcome and all the lessons that you learn in the process, you know. And I feel that I focus most of my time before, like, into learning a lot. And I realize that now I know a lot of stuff that I would love to teach as well. So I guess that actually, it's something that I've been wanting a lot. And I guess it's just setting the right focus into doing this, because this is also part of building community. And I would love to do that through character design. That is something that I would love to have an impact here in Latin America and basically Panama as well, is creating a culture of character design and taking it more seriously, because here people tend to see it as just little drawings, and it's much deeper and stronger than that. So it's something that I really want to take personally and work it through and teach it and learning as well, because I have a lot to learn still, but I know some things, so I would love to do that. I'm Pape, and I'm complete.
Pape. Bob.
Pape, my brother, are you ever really truly complete, though? I mean, the way you sign off, I like that. I love that. Fortunately, I don't think you're complete. I today, like, this is driving it home for it. This is a thing I'm feeling right these last 48 hours. It's so interesting how the universe delivers like perfect moments where stuff, clarity is achieved, right? And as I'm sitting here and I look back at like, look, I'm an old dude. I've been around for a while, right? And my career has swung from like big, shiny, sparkly stuff to focused teaching and community building, right? So I helped to build the TED community. I helped to build the Alt MBA community. You know, I taught at Cal Arts. I reflect back on the episodes where I was either teaching or in that or involved in big community building projects. Those are the projects where my soul was created, where like the things that made me the most happy, you know, were coaching at the Alt MBA or teaching, you know, like seeing students at Cal Arts. So here's what I need to do. Here's the assertion I'm gonna lay down for me in this community, is that I need to find my opportunities to show up as a conduit for what I've learned. Like I need to find my opportunities here at the Systm to teach, to coach, and to give the hands and the head to the community building. And I think if I can make that a focus for that, for me here and in how I'm showing up everywhere this year, I think it's gonna be, that's the year I need to have.
Future is so bright. So guys, we're about 5 minutes over and I wanna be respectful of everyone's time. Is there anyone else that would like to share before we au revoir to everyone? Ginder, please.
Hi. I think this is amazing. I mean, my growth has excelled coming here and connecting with everyone. And like I was just passive all the time, but that was really helpful. Gave me growth, and everything goes back to, you know, what you guys saying and like, you know, the whole new mind being the storyteller, and there's abundance for everyone. And I see that it's this platform is opportunity to grow and have access opportunities and participation. And that's wonderful. At the end of the day, that connection is really strong, because I think there's what you're saying is with the culture and community is moving towards not growth domestic product, because that's not helpful for the planet. It should be like gross domestic happiness, and it comes from inside us, like how we behave, how we connect. And then what we buy as well, what we buy into. So that's what I'm going to say. So I thought I'd unmute myself today. Thank you
for unmuting yourself, Ginder. Gross domestic happiness.
Oh man, that's
a bar right
that
there.
That is it, man. That's the measure of life right there.
Oh, Ginder, thank you so much for that share. Arsa, Take us home, brother.
Yeah, I mean, on the topic of today's episode, just think that I noticed today speaking with some Serbian partners, and it is really like all these things that we talk about, I think then the most important part of them is kind of embodying them and kind of showing up and kind of showing this, modeling these patterns in your own life, and on the topic of the core, and also on the topic of flow and like hero journey. I really think that like, it is stupid, and maybe because it's so old quote, when we hear it, we forgot it, but really kind of being what we want, kind of being the change, embodying that what we want is the way forward. Because just today I kind of noticed that things that I kind of, that we speak here and the way we relate here is not like in the same way everywhere, and just kind of assuming that. And then when you, Sergio would say, when you go and interact with normies, it's difficult. But then I just noticed that by kind of being myself in front of other people that are maybe at the moment afraid to be themselves, it kind of just opens them. So it's really kind of changing through modeling, not through kind of push, like, oh, you should show up as yourself, but just kind of leading through example. So I'm Arsene and I'm good.
Brother, thank you, brother. That was such a dope dare. You know, I think there's something to be said for unmuting yourself allows for you to inspire others to unmute themselves. Thank you, guys. So, you know, we're coming up to the end of today's jam sesh, hanging out culturally and interacting and sharing the ideas and exchanging and vibing and connecting. It's always a beautiful thing, and it's always a wonderful way to end the week. If you're catching this, you know, on any of the channels, we invite you to like, subscribe, and comment. I just want to remind you, you know, what our schedule is for the next couple months. So we will be, every week, we'll be alternating between either design therapy or office hours, and they'll be right here. And here we are through March. And again, right, this is the Systm. You know, we are the Systm, you are the Systm. We're building the future, y'all. We are going to make it.
So much LFG. Love, everyone.
LFG, baby, let's fucking let's do it.
Bye bye.
I'm excited people. For everyone here. Thank you guys for all, you know, showing up, for meeting yourselves, for vibing, for sharing the knowledge, for stepping out and teaching and educating, for mentoring. This is a space for everyone to be their best selves and their truest selves and their most authentic selves. And that is how we have the best possible community that we can have. So y'all, the last three, you are more powerful than you know. Your creativity is limited only by your imagination. And together, we are going to build it. I love you all. Take care. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday.
Have a nice weekend, everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you for dropping by. See you next week. Same time. Ha ha ha.